It's time to put on our thinking caps and interpret the significance of what we've been exploring. For unless it explains, history is trivial. Did you discover anything unexpected this week that needs to be explained? In your explorations of 17th century science, you encountered different, sometimes contradictory explanations. Interpretations have varied immensely over time and continue to be disputed today. In particular, historians debate the relative importance in 17th century science of three approaches to nature we might characterize as the mathematical, the mechanical, and the organicist traditions. In contrast to the last 2 weeks when our focus was on the mathematical astronomy of Copernicus and the mathematical physics of Galileo, this week we have turned to the mechanical and organicist traditions. The mechanical philosophy of Descartes and Gassendi plays a prominent role in traditional accounts of the scientific revolution. But many historians also argue that the chemical philosophy and other organicist perspectives played a more constructive role in the so-called scientific revolution than has been widely recognized. Imagine that you are at a coffee house talking with a friend in the middle of the 17th century. Your conversation touches upon various lively discoveries recently touted by adherents of the mechanical philosophy and by those with various organicist philosophies. You are familiar with the phenomena of magnetism and a wide range of chemical reactions. You are also familiar with clear and compelling explanations of a wide range of phenomena offered in terms of matter and motion. Which view of nature, the mechanical or organicist, appears on the whole more convincing to you? What is nature? Is nature better known when understood as a machine, as inert matter in motion, or when understood as having active and self-organizing powers? Can the organicist philosophies explain nature in a clear and compelling manner without recourse to emblems and mysteries? Can the mechanical philosophy explain the properties of magnets and chemical reactions? What specific evidence or discoveries make a stronger impression on you in favor of the mechanical philosophy or in support of the organicist philosophies? Finally, another issue raised by the scientific revolution is the question of science and the human place in nature. At the beginning of this course, we characterized Aristotelian philosophy as a philosophy of common sense. Historians often say that modern science, from Copernican astronomy to the mechanical philosophy, drove a wedge between expert knowledge and common sense. In what ways have our topics this week and in the last 2 or 3 weeks, revealed a progressive separation between scientific explanations and common sensory experience? If so, might our story of the scientific revolution need to account for an increasing sense of alienation between ordinary human life and theoretical science? That is, was the sense of dislocation between human experience and science solely due to Copernicus, or did it have something to do with the setting aside of common sensory experience as the key to how nature is known? What is the most significant implication of what you have learned this week? What is your interpretation?